Blackstone IAS Academy. I'm Dr. Radhe, and I will be teaching economics optional for the UPSC mains examination. As we all know that economics is the lifeblood of all administration. The success rate of choosing economics as an optional is pretty good. In this video, first, I shall introduce the course and tell you how to approach the subject and discuss the pattern of questions since 2013. Speak about the advantages and disadvantages in choosing economics as your optional. And finally, how to excel in it. The course at the Capstone IAS Academy would cover the syllabus with virtual classroom lectures accompanied by continuous evaluation through tests. The program would highlight on the coverage of the past year question paper and potential questions for the future. Interactive sessions will be an integral part of the program. The duration of the course will be for 5 months. Now, I shall explain about the syllabus mentioned for the UPSC Economics optional. The Economics optional subject has two papers, paper one consisting of 250 marks and paper two, 250 marks, bringing the total to 500 marks. Paper one consists of the following branches of economics. Say microeconomics, macroeconomics, international economics, economics of growth and development, money and banking, and public finance. So you will have a few portions of all these subjects in paper one. Paper two consists of Indian economy by and large, and we will be studying the various time periods of the Indian economy, like Indian economy before 1947, that is comprising the pre-independence period, Indian economy between 1947 and 1991, and Indian economy after 1991 till the present date. So this is all about the syllabus for the economics optional. Now, having glanced through the syllabus, how do we understand the paper economics? Well, this can have a two-way approach. Firstly, have a good conceptual clarity. Understanding of the economic concepts like national income, GDP, CRR, repo, reverse repo, and so on. And second approach is the application of these concepts in the day-to-day situations. So firstly, have a good conceptual clarity, and secondly, apply the concepts in the day-to-day situations. Now, moving to the question pattern since 2013, say over the past 8 years, from which area have the questions been asked in the UPSC examinations? Say, approximately some 36 questions have been asked from microeconomics, 38 questions from macroeconomics. And as far as money, banking, and public finance, there are some 30 questions being asked from this area, 38 questions from international economics, 40 questions from development theory, and there are some 15 odd questions which we can group under the miscellaneous category, because these are, you know, covering economics by and large, questions have been asked. So this we can group under the miscellaneous category. Now, what do we infer from this brief analysis of the question pattern? There can be two highlights out of this. Say one, go for a balanced approach. Prepare, have a balanced approach in your preparation. And secondly, give equal weightage to all the topics, all the areas mentioned in the syllabus. So this could be the two inferences, that is, have go for a balanced approach and assign equal weightage to all the topics mentioned in your syllabus. Now, highlighting about the advantages and disadvantages in choosing economics as your optional paper. Firstly, the advantages. Economics is a scoring subject with specific and clear-cut syllabus. The books and the materials mentioned in the syllabus have easy and ready availability in the market. Economics is a rational and a logical subject, and all you need to have is a conceptual clarity. There is no prior knowledge of the subject required, and this makes the engineering graduates and the science stream students also to go in choosing economics as their optional subject without any prior knowledge. The economics subject would cover 60% of the UPSC syllabus for GS paper 3, and students can easily score some 30 marks in their preliminary examination. A good understanding of the graphs can really make you score very well in the subject. Now, moving to the disadvantages, like any other subject for that matter, you need to have a special interest and liking for the subject, which is very essential. And as economics is a technical subject, you need to be precise in your answers. And graphs are predominant, and you need to have a thorough knowledge of graphs. Now, having chosen economics as your optional paper, here are a few tips to really make you score very well and to excel in the subject. Firstly, avoid equations and use graphs instead. Be careful in using the right technical words. For example, when you have to specify or speak about revenue, do not use the term income. Income is different from revenue. Like this, there can be some concepts or some technical word usage which can really be misleading when it is being used wrongly. Always give examples from real life to rationalize your answers. This makes you score well, and also you are telling the examiner that you have an expertise over the subject. Use figures and data to validate your answers. I hope this video has given some useful insights in choosing economics as your optional subject. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.